So here we go. Hopefully the last time I tried to do a full run of this game, I got frustrated because I got RNG butt raped, basically. So let's try it again. If I actually finish this run, it'll be world record. So, yay. It's refreshing to do the beginning of the game again, actually. The end game is just so ridiculous in comparison. If you have any questions about this game, ask. Even though I described it as just being a piece of nonsense, which it is, I have quite a depth of knowledge about this game, actually. Probably more so than most people, which is... I haven't been watching the marathon at all since I've been up, and I've only been up for like an hour. Dude, when I fell asleep... That's what I heard. I did hear about the trouble they were having, so... that. Beginning of the game goes usually a little smoother than the rest of the game. Biggest thing with this run in general in the end is going to be hoping for good RNG, which I am not a fan of. This entire run after stage 2 is dictated by RNG, which is just awful. I'm a huge fan of having a balanced run, like some RNG to keep you on your toes and a lot of execution. And this run just doesn't. Oh god, somebody got a Wii U, watch out. Hey Jungle Book. You're witnessing maybe the first ever full run of Sneak King. Maybe. It depends on what happens in construction site mostly. And downtown, but mostly construction site. Okay, we got really good RNG here. I need to pick up a Wii U at some point too, and there's only one game I really want to pick up for it mostly, other than Smash, and that'd be Pikmin 3. I also wouldn't mind having Mario Kart 8. I think my least played console is probably my original Xbox. I play my frigging Atari Jaguar more than I play that thing. See, the reality with this run, Jungle Book, is that no matter how much I practice it, it's not gonna be that good. Because the whole end game is like ridiculous. It's just RNG butt rape after after getting bent over by the fact that this game sucks. So, like I said, the shorter category is much, much better. It's more plannable, it relies more on the technical skill of the player, rather than a bunch of stupid bullshit. Whoa, okay. Oh yeah, Wind Waker HD. I'd like to get that too. Friggin' level 3 flourishes. Jesus Christ. Hate this challenge. Nice RNG, man. Actually, no, this is pretty good RNG. Oh, nice, dude. I have every Wii U game ever made, and ever will be made, but not really. Okay. Look at this RNG. Look at this RNG. Look at this RNG. Look at it! Look at it! All right, moving on to the cul-de-sac. This used to be my least favorite area, but I think it's actually my favorite now. I don't know what my split is for the 50% run for that area. I think it's a little faster than that, but not much. Whoa! Heyo! Yeah. Good RNG followed by crappy RNG. It happens. Okay. Shut up. Don't care, biznitch. I'm gonna go deliver this big beef patty right up this woman. Shove it right in her stomach. Yes! Okay. This is a really weird challenge already. I want red. Yay. In America. Not the US, America. Shove it right in her boobs. Alright. That was actually a really good challenge, even though it didn't even go out how it normally does, not even a little. 5 deliveries. 5 inventory. Okay, it started off with the guy up there. Okay. See, here's the deal. A good majority of this game is RNG, which I'm actually okay with. But a lot of it's still kind of plannable. Like, things kind of still happen in the general area that they normally do, if that makes any sense. But the last two areas of this game, particularly Construction Site, does not follow that formula. Everything happens for no reason whatsoever the entire time. This has been a really weird cul-de-sac, comparatively. Alright, let's go get this guy! This challenge actually has a real route. Oh god! A route? God forbid this game actually makes sense. Hooray! What are you gonna do, game? Okay, you're gonna skip her. And then she's gonna get hungry like right now, isn't she? Watch this, watch this. This woman in the green dress, watch this. Oh goody. Well, my friends, that is an example of how this game is complete horse shit. 2K points, 1 delivery. Yee. This one's really easy. Go, go, go! Done. Constant action. I like this next challenge. It starts off with a woman standing in this doorway, ringing a bell, but she rings it like pushing the air. She like rings it in the wrong direction. Just watch this shit. Watch this shit. Lol. Such programming. Then this guy right at 145. And then I'm gonna like run up to this corner here and watch this big orgy of people, and it's someone random out of it every time. Every time. Okay. Did you see those strats? Did you see those strats? I didn't. Who's next? Nice. Getting really good RNG to start off with for this challenge. The first two deliveries in this one are scripted, and then after that they're RNG. Oh, wow. Man. This RNG is ridiculous. Wow, dude. For real. I don't think I've ever had RNG this good on this challenge. Like, not even in practice. And then bam. Like right over here. That's actually really good. Really, really good. Dude, nice. I still use a CRT. I don't want to use an HDMI. Screw that. I've never owned an HDMI TV, and I never will, so Screw that. I don't want to. Okay, we live. Nope, screwed up. Dude, I don't care how much it costs. I don't care if someone was like, you can have this CRT TV for $10, or you can have this HDMI TV for free. I would buy the CRT TV. What's my timer at? That's about right. Yellow Max, I believe, is what I do for this one. Yeah, it's Yellow Max. Okay. I browned it, but that's alright. Actually, let me correct that. I do have one HDMI TV, and it is currently being used as my computer monitor. Wait, what? Oh. I don't know, I just don't like new TVs. I like old TVs. So, I'm gonna... Mine is a 42 inch, and it's probably right at about 350 pounds, actually. See, I can't use any sort of HDMI for any console other than PS3 or 360. And I rarely... This is the only game I play on 360 ever. Seriously, this is it. I have like 10... It's like I have like 1,500 games. I have like 6 360 games. And then my PS3, I just use AV because I don't care. Even though I know it would look a lot better with HDMI. I just really don't care. Come on. Ooh. What are you wanting? Nice. Shit tier RNG. Oh, dude, I don't want any friggin' 360 games. I have all the ones I want. That's all that matters. I don't like the 360. It's one of my least favorite consoles. That was 5 seconds off world record. I have... like, The Darkness, The Devil May Cry Trilogy, which I also own on PS2, Fable 3, a couple versions of FF11, FF13, 13-2, Sneak King, Lost Odyssey. I just don't like the 360. It's a shit system. That's like, complete shit tier. They break too easy, and they're literally... They're literally just like a bunch of FPSs and Western RPGs. And Sneak King. Okay, that was weird. I like how the music glitched out there. That was pretty good. My gaming experience, pretty much, I stick strictly to retro. This is the newest game I run, and I don't... If I ever ran another modern game... quote-unquote modern, it would probably be The Last of Us. There's certain missions that you do lose if you get caught, but the goal of this particular mission is to get seen by every citizen in the on the stage. So I'm doing it on purpose. And the reason this is quicker is because when you do a delivery, the time actually stops, if you noticed. So yeah. We're getting ready to get to the real shit tier challenges about halfway through this stage that are like stupid difficult and stupid irritating. I like how the music just glitched out and just stopped. Really short challenge, and this next one's extremely short, which is why I do it. This next challenge is pretty difficult. Actually, I just picked up a new PS3 game. I picked up Tales of Zillia. I've really been enjoying it casually. It's just such a good game. I do need to get Dead Rising, though, actually. I don't have any of them. This challenge really sucks, FYI. I don't like PC games very much. I'm a strictly console guy. Unless they're hunting games. Dude, I think hunting games are the most unexplored, best genre of game. I'm not even kidding. Someone should speedrun hunting games. Okay, one more delivery and this challenge is over. Thank God. This challenge is scary. I'm actually serious. This challenge is really scary. Because of how just backwards ass broken it is. Comparatively. Ooh, ooh, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Alright, we're gonna have to wait for the cycle to restart, which should be about another 20 to 30 seconds. And I would rather do that than fail at this point. Dude, what's up, Ghoul? I am very glad that challenge is over. That challenge is cringe-worthingly difficult, actually. This isn't a florist challenge, is it? Stupid pipe. I'm okay with this. I can work with this. Woo! Okay, I can work with this too. Okay, so here's where things really go down the shitter. This next challenge is literally like 8 deliveries, all RNG. And the thing that makes it suck so much is because this level is so disconnected. So in the meantime, while there's not really a lot of people getting hungry, I'm going to try and connect the level as much as I can. Not going to make it to him in time. That's not happening. I can make it to these guys, though. I can cross my fingers here. And it worked. I have 4 TVs, I think. I only really use one of them regularly, though. One of them's just kind of my Netflix machine. And the other big one is for, like, consoles. And then I have 2 smaller ones. One of them I'm using as a computer monitor because I didn't feel like buying a monitor. When I had a computer, I could just... Or when I had a TV, I could just essentially use as a monitor. This actually is, despite the bad RNG and the dumb mistakes, this actually is not going all that horribly. Dude, look at that. Look at the inside of that burger. Look at the inside of that burger model. That's the sexiest thing you've ever seen, and you know it is. Yeah, getting over there is a bit too time-consuming. Dude, I play the shit out of my Wii. Oh, no, get this, guys. So I was doing a Kirby 64 run for a speedathon yesterday, and it softlocked on VC. Like, it legit softlocked during the run on VC. I was like, oh my god, I lost like 7 minutes. I barely climbed in under my estimate, actually, because of it. It was pretty horrible. Like, I mean, I know I couldn't help it, but it was really weird. I was like, what the heck? How does VC softlock? I've never even, like... That was never even a thing with Kirby 64 in general, let alone VC. Like, I don't know. It legit softlocked, though. It, like, went... Like, I was like, what the actual... Like, god dang it. Oh, the run went well after that. It just... Okay, I really hate this challenge. This challenge really sucks. It's highly possible that I will fail it to start off with. Which would obviously be dildos. Dildos. So this area is kind of weird in that you want to do Florist Level 3s because the animation for Florist Level 3 is shorter than an animation for a Floor's Level 2 in this stage. You can be seen, but I don't want to because I don't want to lose my chain count. You can't be seen when you're in an animation, so I wasn't too worried about that douchebag seeing me. So we're just gonna go up here. We're gonna catch the end of this guy's hunger cycle. That should have completed the challenge, which is really nice. Yes, that went shockingly well compared to how it could go. And I'm way ahead of schedule, actually. This run might be quite a bit shorter than what I thought it would be at this point. Alright, this next challenge is Flourishes, I believe. Five Flourishes. This one actually also has a preset, which is nice. Very nice. I came around the long way, which is unlike me. Dude, I got this game past first round cuts for AGDQ. I believe, I have faith that this will be at AGDQ. I believe in the king, and the king will believe in you. He didn't see me. Eat my shit! Yeah, this is actually, I'm quite a bit under schedule. We still have one more pretty shit tier delivery to do. It's basically the same as that one challenge, only it's 9 deliveries instead of 8. So we're gonna go ahead and do that now. The reason I actually even do this one is because it unlocks a really short challenge that's entirely scripted. So what I actually, the more I play these, the more I like them, because they require me to improvise what I'm doing entirely. The only thing I have scripted with this challenge is the fact that, I'll hold you to that, man. Dude, I'll hold you to that because I'm a broke motherfucker. No, you don't have to do that, though, really. What all did you submit for that marathon? We're gonna make it right on time. Okay, we're not gonna make him. Or him. Okay, RNG's being bad to us now. Nice, dude. Okay. You ain't gonna get away from me. Okay, we're only 3 deliveries in. I really wish I was a little bit more in, but it happens. Dude, you should submit .hackgu. Just go back in and edit your post and submit .hackgu. I beg of you. I beg of you to go and submit GU Volume 1. If GU gets in, I will literally ride a donkey to AGDQ. Whatever. Yeah, you can be seen on this challenge. It doesn't matter. Dude, yeah, you are, man. Dude, do it. Okay. Make your estimate 631. Clutch mode. Clutch mode estimate. Good, let him get bored. Screw people. At least you're realistic though, man. I appreciate that. It's like you get... You're gonna pass out before I get there, aren't you? No! Oh, nice. A lot of people submit, like, 10-hour games to GDQs and are like, I don't understand why my game didn't get in. Well, it's because it's an RPG and it's not Final Fantasy. Hate to sound like a douche, but that's kind of the way that works. Okay, last challenge of construction site. We in there. So if you press to hide on the same frame that she sees you, she won't see you. Random little discovery I made. Because when the king enters an animation, you can't be detected. Barely. He was almost out of range. And then we're good on the last delivery. I just looked and checked on my radar. The goal for this challenge is to do 3 deliveries from a hiding place. And although the animation takes a while, it's scripted, which makes it a lot easier. And this area is done. Okay, I'm clocking in at quite a bit less. I think I could shave like 2 minutes off of this still, actually.
A construction site was the unlikely setting yesterday for an impromptu visit from the...
Yeah, that was bad. I didn't skip the thing. So I lost like 5 seconds there because I was busy pulling up my dock to make... Sure, I didn't forget my route. Cool, I got really good RNG. No, that's not the run. We're not done yet. Still have the last area, which isn't as intense as the third area, but it's technically more difficult, I guess. This area actually has a shortcut in it, which I find pretty cool. Yeah, you can do it through the fence. And we're about to utilize the built-in shortcut in this stage. It's whatever. It's about average. Okay, pretty difficult challenge coming up here. Ascending Flourish is part 2. This one's RNG as well. And it's highly possible that I will fail this. Not only on my own technical execution, but RNG can cause me to fail it. Occasionally, the third person won't even get hungry. We got very lucky, and the third person did. Now I just have to... Okay. That's a pretty clutch challenge right there. Nice. Whew. That saves like 0.5 seconds. Okay. Really short challenge here. What the Oh, fudge. That sucks so much. Okay. So, occasionally there's this glitch that can happen where an NPC's line of vision can look through an object, and that's what happened, and he actually saw me first, so I tried to step back and fix it, and I wasn't able to. So, this is gonna get pretty interesting. I'm writing a new route in my head as I go at the moment. That's the guy right there that we need. This last guy here is not too big of a problem. It's gonna look like he's gonna die, but he's gonna walk to the back of the laundromat. Turn red about now. Stand there for like a second, then he's gonna turn around right about now or so. Turn around, there we go. He's gonna start blinking, and he's gonna get here right on time. And then our last guy got hungry again. So I could save some time on this challenge for sure, but it's gonna be fairly hit and miss. We're gonna beat him before he goes inside. I have faith. What's he doing? Taking a garbage out? Yeah, we can do it. Okay. That could have went better, but it could have went a lot worse. I've gotten the really hard challenges. That's actually a pretty easy one. I just kind of got screwed over. This challenge here is pretty cool. You have to do 5 deliveries to people with the lowest level of hunger. And the first 2 deliveries are scripted. Or they're supposed to be. Okay. Welcome to Sneak King. Everything's made up and the programming doesn't matter. And I mean that, literally. This game is just stuff happens or doesn't happen. Okay, I can't deliver to her anymore. Got to him right on time. I'm not gonna reach him in time. I did. Okay. Okay. that could have went better as well, and it once again could have went worse. This challenge here is pretty irritating. Is anybody even still watching? Beautiful. If I get lucky, I can catch this woman before she turns the corner. Nope. That's okay, though. She's gonna come back. As soon as the door opens. This challenge is also RNG after the third delivery. If you haven't realized that yet, that's kind of why I'm just running around. Problem with this game and how much RNG is actually at the end, makes it not even feel like a speedrun almost. Makes it feel like you're casually playing it. Almost. Oh, this is nice. This is cool RNG. I'll accept this. Is it laundromat guy again? Okay. Can I catch you? No. Okay, just one more delivery and this one's over. And then we're on pretty much the home stretch of the run. Three more challenges and the run's over. Next one here, 3 level 3 flourishes. It's very possible that I'll fail this one. And then we have a pretty long challenge after that. But it's a fun one. So this one's RNG as well, but you only have to do 3 deliveries, which makes it pretty easy. But if I fail, I have to start the whole... If I fail one of these flourishes, I have to start the whole challenge over, which obviously really sucks. So far, so good. I feel pretty proud that I actually finally done this run. It's been a long time in the making. Okay, one more delivery on this one, and this challenge is finished. And RNG is on our side, because we got this guy right here. Okay. Whew. Okay, that's the last of the really horrible challenges. Then we have this one. This challenge is extremely easy. I put it at the end on purpose. You have to do 8 deliveries and then wait till the timer expires. The reason it's quick is because the challenge after it is pretty quick. So, there's still some room for some optimizations here and there, especially in the last two areas, but areas 1 and 2 are very optimized at this point, because no one was routing it. I've solely worked on it. Now, 100% is going to happen a bit later. This challenge here is really easy. You can be seen as many times. You only have to do 8 deliveries in 3 minutes, which is ridiculously easy. And then after we get them all done, we're just going to hide somewhere and just, I'm going to show off a feature of the game that you don't get to do in the run because it doesn't serve a purpose. This run is almost over, and it's going to sub 1 hour like I originally wanted it to. which is quite nice. Knock on wood, though. Let's hope it actually ends well. This challenge here is also RNG, but it's all circumnavigable because you have to wait for the clock to expire anyway. Okay, we'll just go around. Excuse me. Did I just one frame him? Wow, I did. Nice. He died on the same frame that I done the delivery. You heard the little birds go. That's actually pretty funny. Alright, so that's all you gotta do delivery-wise, so... we're gonna hide in this phone booth. And we're just gonna stare at people till the clock runs out. And then the last challenge we gotta do, challenge 6, is pretty darn difficult, but... not impossible. All in all, sub 50 is gonna be stretching it at this point, I think. The game probably still might sub 55. I think with a little bit more practice on execution, I could comfortably say an hour estimate is very, very doable with this run. An hour 5 tops. So we're just gonna like creepily stare at people. Yeah, that guy. We wanna get out before the timer elapses though. Final challenge of the run! Woo! Chain count of 5, which means 5 deliveries without being seen or heard. We have 2 minutes to do it. Clutch mode! Incoming world record! Don't get too excited. Don't get too excited. Okay, run. Playing it a little safe, just to make sure. Okay, there's 2 of 5. Alright, it's almost over. It's almost over. Come on, come on. Okay, there's 1. If you can at all do a delivery immediately following another delivery, it's a good thing, because you have a few moments of complete immunity to being seen or heard for just a couple moments. Come on, someone nearby, so I don't have to... this is it! This is it! This is it! We done! We in there! Alright! I have been meaning to pull that off for some time. 5402. I think the next goal with this is going to be about a 52 minutes. Biggest time saves could come from really good RNG in the last area, basically. Some RNG in construction site. and Sawmill and Cul-de-sac were about as quick as they can get. Actually, my cul-de-sac split is only 5 seconds off my world record for the shorter category. I like how the game froze during the credits there for a minute. Alright. Yeah, sub 55 was actually my long-term goal for this, which I shattered on the first run, which I didn't expect. So that's actually really good. I mainly just wanted to have a recorded PB of this, to be totally honest.